Yo, Ozzy, hurry up and get ready, man. Fucking hell, stop messing around. Get dressed. We're about to go deer hunting in a second. Look, I've already got my weapon ready. You're there, buddy, mucking around doing nothing. Far out, Ozzy, man. You're bloody useless. What are you talking about, Ben? I've already got my outfit. I've got me 22 ready. Jesus Christ, do you really think I'm a slack ass? Bloody Ben, man. Just thinks I just sit there all day drinking coffees. I mean, I kind of do. Oh, well. What do you mean you're ready, Ozzy? Look at you. Look at the outfit. You look like a Christmas tree on Christmas Day. You're all friggin' lit up and bloody sparkly and pretty. And second of all, you got a 22 and that's only going to be able to take down a rabbit, not a deer. Jesus. Ozzy, just, man, when will you get it? A 22 and he looks like a Christmas tree. We're just missing the presents now. Far out. Get dressed again. What do you mean, Ben? What's wrong with my outfit? I thought you wore orange when you went out deer hunting. And I mean, I guess you're right about the 22. But I've got something better than a 22, if that makes you feel better. And I've got an outfit that you're really gonna like. So I'll go get dressed and I'll be back again.
Hey, Ben.
What do you think of my outfit now? I'm all camouflaged, deer's not gonna be able to see me. Oh, yeah, also, not to mention this brand new gun that I got as well that's gonna be able to take down any deer, unlike that 22 I had. So what do you reckon? We get in the car, Ben, and let's go. Woo!
Fuck me dead, Ozzy. Just get in the car, man. Just get in the car. You know what? If anyone wants to go hunting, don't go hunting with Ozzy Shooter because he just fucks around, wastes your time. The only good thing that he does is his YouTube channel, so make sure you guys subscribe and hit that like button as well. And I'm out of here. If he's not ready in 10 minutes, I'm just leaving him. I'm going. I'm going, Ozzy. Bye.
What is going on, everybody? My name is Ozzy Shooter, and welcome to my channel where we review guns, knives, and crossbows, and we also do gaming. So in today's review, we're going to be taking a look at Remington's Model 700, chambered in 243. That is right, guys. So we're going to be taking a look at some of the specs of this rifle, and also why I chose a 243 caliber over many others. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's get into this review right now. Alrighty guys, today we're going to be taking a look at this Remington Model 700 chambered in 243 SPS kit. Now, this is an absolutely beautiful rifle. Now, you may wonder why I went for a 243 instead of some other calibers. Now, the reason for is I did competition shooting for about a couple of months, about 5 months, and I really fell in love with the caliber 308. And I was looking around on the market for a good 308. And one day I went in there to go have a look to see what they had. And this popped up on the shelf second hand. This isn't new. And I fell in love with it. It's a really, really nice kit. Came with this awesome scope and everything sort of what I was looking for, but not in a 308. And it was a good price, so I couldn't resist it. So I picked it up. And also 243 is really good because I like to do hunting as well as a little bit of competition shooting, like I said. So this will allow me to do both. And, you know, there's not too much you can't take down with a 243 caliber. And also, you know, you can do, you know, good competition shooting with it too. You know, accurate out to 500 yards. So, you know, you probably won't be able to make it. I mean, you probably could stretch it out to 8 to 1,000 yards if you really tried. But, you know, overall, I don't think anyone's going to be really shooting any further than 500 yards if you're out hunting, to be honest. But yeah, it has a multi-purpose barrel on it too. So if you don't know what a multi-purpose barrel is, it means it's a both a competition and a hunting barrel. So the difference between a hunting barrel and a competition barrel is built a lot stronger because you're going to be putting a lot more rounds through your barrel than you would if you had a hunting rifle. So a hunting barrel isn't as strong, so it means you're going to wear out your barrel very quickly. Whereas a multi-purpose is a bit of both, so that means it could take a little bit more of a beating before you have to replace the barrel. So that's a pretty cool thing there. So like I said, I like to do both. So it gives me both options. You know, I'm not a full-time competition shooting person, but if, you know, I wanted to go on the range and, you know, practice my skills and hone this, you know, put this scope into practice and stuff like that, and better my skills, I can also do that as well. So let's get into the specs of this rifle. Now, the overall length of this rifle is 43 and 63 inches, and the overall weight of this is 7.25 labs. So it is a quite a hefty rifle, but that's without a scope, so I wouldn't have any clue on how much it would weigh with this big scope, but it does weigh a bit. My arm's starting to get a little bit sore, but just holding it in one hand, but it's not anything bad. Like, this is a rifle you could, you know, walk a fair distance while out hunting without getting too sore. But also, you do have an optional sling point here and here, so if you didn't want to carry it around, you know, you can strap it to your back and, you know, hold onto it and switch it from shoulder to shoulder. So instead of having to wear your arms out, so when it comes time to taking down that deer, your arms aren't going to be all jiggly. It has a 12 and 38th length of pull, so it's quite a short but, you know, medium sized length of pull, which is, you know, cool to get those rounds down range or at your target, but not anything too crazy. It also only holds four in the magazine. Now, it has a non-removable magazine, so if you don't know what a non-removable magazine means, you can't take it out, it's attached to the rifle. But if you want to get the rounds out, if you've taken a couple of shots and you've still got some in there and you don't want to leave them in there, what you have to do is up here by the trigger guard is a little clip. Just press that button and all the shells will fall out. But be warned, like I said, they're going to fall out everywhere on the ground and then they're going to get dirty and then you're going to have to clean them up. So I would suggest putting your hand under there to catch them. So to put it back, all you have to do is push this in and clip it back in. Now to remove the bolt, it's very simple as well. You have to pull the bolt back, as you know. And then up here is a little button under this, up the top here, right up there. You just need to press that up above the trigger and your bolt will come out. Now it has a two lugged bolt face, so you know it's quite a strong little bolt. It weighs a fair bit as well. And then to install it, you don't have to press any triggers or anything like that. You just push it in, clicks in once you hear that click, and away you go. And also, speaking of the bolt, look how smooth this action is. It is so smooth. Look, pinky. It's pinky smooth, man. Really, really good rifle. Now, it has a 9.5 1/8 of a twist in the barrel. So it's got a nice little twist in the barrel for pushing them down range. Now, the muzzle velocity is about 300 feet per second straight from the muzzle. And obviously that changes per distances. I can't remember what it was at 500 yards. I think it was only about like, I think maybe 12, 13,000 feet per second, about 500 yards when it's hitting the target at that range, obviously. So it's quite a very powerful rifle. The most powerful rifle I have in my gun collection at the moment. Like my 22 is only about 1100 feet per second at the barrel. So that's once it's left the barrel. And obviously as it gets further in distances, it obviously starts slowing down because it starts dropping because gravity takes its place. It has a metal blued finish on this barrel, so you shouldn't run into any big rust problems unless you scratch the barrel up and obviously, you know, keep it very well maintained and oiled. Like I said, I picked this thing up secondhand, and the only scuffs that I found was here on the polymer stock. And then also back here on your recoil pad, it's also a little bit melted. So I don't know what happened there. I kind of think you might have left it near a fire and it's gotten melted. It's all a bit sticky, but you know, it's a recoil pad. As long as it reduces the recoil, it doesn't really matter. It doesn't need to look pretty, to be honest, because you know, this is my hunting rig after all. And they're not there to sit in your safe looking pretty. They need to be out there being used. Now, it has an R3 recoil pad on this rifle, so it's quite nice to reduce some of that recoil, which is really cool. And it also has a 24-inch hammered forged barrel as well, so quite a strong barrel on this gun. But yeah, very, very good. I recommend getting this gun if you guys were looking at getting a nice hunting gun and you couldn't decide on what caliber you wanted. I would recommend a 243 because, like I said, they'll take down just about anything. And weighs about 7.25 labs. I don't know if I said that already. I think I did, but just in case I didn't. But yeah, 4 in the mag, quite a nice little rig. Really looking forward to taking this out. I haven't yet shot this rifle yet, so really looking forward to testing it out and seeing how it goes. I might take it to the range maybe next weekend and maybe do some footage if they allow me to film there on the range. But also, filming on the range can be a little bit difficult as well because you've got other people there obviously doing competition shooting as well. So my audio quality will probably be really bad. So I need to try and wait till I can get access to a property where I can, you know, just set up the camera and I can shoot without any background noise and stuff like that. All right, guys, hope that you guys did enjoy this review on the 243. If you guys have any more questions about this rifle, definitely leave them in the comment section below. I'll be happy to answer anybody about it. But like I said, if you're looking at getting a rifle, definitely recommend this Remington 243 model 700 SPS kit. Also, another thing quickly before I sign off, they also have other model 700s as well. So Remington model 700 308, Remington model 700 30-06, and I think they even have 6.5 Creedmoor as well, and then you've got your 243. I think there's another caliber as well, but I can't think of it at the moment, but you can Google it as well. Because when I was first Googling, I was like, Remington model 700, and all I could find on the internet was 308 reviews for this gun, like Model 700. I'm like, but mine's a 243. I'm so confused. But yeah, so this is probably going to be the first review on YouTube of a Model 700 243. So I'm really excited about that as well. All right, guys, as always, catch you in the next one.